The talk of the neighborhood on South Peninsula Drive in Daytona Beach over the past couple of weeks has been the impending auction of a luxury home of Betty Jane France. Betty Jane France passed away last August, and the family has put the home up for auction. France and her husband, Bill France Jr., built the home in 2003 off South Peninsula, overlooking the Halifax River. The home is quite a showplace and one that Betty Jane France was very proud of. Betty Jane worked with an architect in Winter Park and built the home based on the Addison Misner style of Mediterranean revival. The villa boasts more than 17,000 square feet and such interesting amenities as an elevator and a guest home. Betty Jane designed the foyer to pop, to be the grand entrance when you walked in through the big wooden panel front doors. The home features a black and white tile reminiscent of the checkered flags that wave at the end of every NASCAR race. Betty Jane's husband, Bill France, was the son of Bill and Ann France, who founded NASCAR in Daytona Beach in 1947 and built Daytona International Speedway in 1959. The home was planned as a place where the Frances could entertain guests who were in town for NASCAR events and for the annual pre-Daytona 500 party. The showplace is valued on Volusia County property appraiser records for about $5 million, but is believed to be insured for roughly $13 million. Betty Jane invited the News Journal into her home on the night before she was having one of her famous pre-Daytona 500 Grand Marshal parties. The foyer was set up to feed about 50 people seated at tables. The tables were covered in beautiful navy blue linens, glittering silver plates, and huge vases overflowing with fragrant white blossoms, milky orchids and roses that filled the room with a wonderful aroma. As guests walked into the room, you could see the beautiful grand staircase that is one of the features of the grand foyer. A living area overlooking the Halifax River features a lot of gold tones and warm hues from the wood and gold in the furniture. The river room features a bar, a good gathering place for their guests, and a living room on the other side of that offers views of the lawn and of the Halifax. Off to the left was a room where Betty Jane liked to watch TV, and then her home office, which she had specially designed so that she could get up in the morning and go to work in her pajamas if she wanted to. The charming room featured snapshots of France's family, her children and grandchildren, as well as some of the many celebrities who she had entertained through the years, including one of her favorite snapshots with Matthew McConaughey. But she also entertained politicians and others, and once joked with President Reagan that it was much easier to have a party at his house than it was to endure the security required to entertain him at her home. It was a place where she loved to relax and spend time with her children and grandchildren. She built the home with Charlie Clayton, an architect out of Winter Park, who worked with her on all the many details that she wanted to get right. Betty Jane joked that her husband, for the most part, stayed out of the planning for the home and let her do what she wanted, but he got involved when it came to the circular brick driveway and the landscaping. She said he wasn't all that interested in some of the details. She, however, was very interested in the detail and those matters. She said even right down to the doorknobs, and she continued to finesse different details of the house right on through the years, even after she moved in. As you walk through the home, there are beautiful balconies and patios that overlook the river. They overlook a pool area. There's a lovely small gas fire pit with a conversation area where people can relax over the fire and watch the sunset. There's a pool, and there is statuary that reflects Betty Jane's interest in helping children in the community, particularly as a benefactress for the Halifax Medical Center and their speediatrics. The home also features a guest house and the living area. We were not invited to it. Tour the rest of the living area, but members of Betty Jane's Garden Club laughed about the enormous closet off her bedroom. They said was as big as many bedrooms they had in their own homes. The home also featured a large basement, and Betty Jane joked that she had amassed quite a collection of greeting cards and wrapping paper. Neighbors in the community say that the traffic has been busy as different people have come to tour the home and take a look. Whoever buys the home on Saturday obviously will be inheriting a beautiful showplace overlooking the Halifax River that will all be decided at this auction on Saturday. We look forward to hearing more details.